was trying to pop my motor at me Tuesday the year before. People climbing out of camper vans, falling to the floor. So I asked the parking marshal what I should do. He said, there's parking over there for the likes of you. It was somewhere in the distance, barely in view. So I turned back to the marshal and I said, fuck you. He said, you're what? I said, fuck you. He said, you're what? I said, fuck you. He shook his head. He said, you come to these events and expect us to provide a wheelchair seat. He said, there's nothing special about you. Got no reason not to treat you like the rest. I said, well done, mate, now you've got it, let's not jest. He rolled his eyes, he was so dazed and confused. So I muttered to myself and I thought out loud, fuck you. He found the viewing platform about a mile from the main stage. It was full of happy campers who were crisp just for the day. So I asked the platform marshal where I could get a better view. He said something about a fuck and never happy people like you. But when I saw where he was pointing and where I had to do, I turned and pointed in disbelief and I said, fuck you. He said, you're what? I said, fuck you. He said, you're what? I said, fuck you. He turned away. He got on his radio, started to whinge and to complain. He told his boss that we were stroppy and we wouldn't face the front. So I shouted to his boss, I thought her marshal was a clown. Till in the end I threatened we'd be removed. So I pointed out that all I said was fuck you. To make these matters worse, for the bog I waited an age, only to find they'd been locked in lockdown, not just engaged. So I asked the toilet marshal where I could do my number two. He said, there's toilets backstage, that should do. So when I saw the line twisting miles to the room, I crossed my legs and getting desperate, said fuck you. He said, you're what? I said fuck you. He said, you're what? I said fuck you. He raised his fist. But he said, you dick irate, as I couldn't even take a piss. He said, there's no need for you to take that attitude. I said, listen mate, I'm done with platitudes. But in the end, I couldn't wait and I went all over his shoes. And he went mad and I just stopped and I said, fuck you. And whilst I'm not averse to swearing or being rude, I found the situation made me unusually rude. But when the atmosphere and service are just crap, then I should be forgiven if my patience finally snaps. But in the end, there's nothing else that you can do than loose your tongue and loose your rag and shout, get stuffed.